In this video, I want to show you how to remove the background with PhotoDirector 10 by using the mask feature. This is something that's new in PhotoDirector 10. And this is the photo that we're going to be working with. I didn't do a perfect job on it just because I wanted to get it done fairly quickly just to get this video uploaded as soon as possible. But when you work on it, you can be more exact with it and use the different tools that I'm going to show you in this video. So I hope you like this video, and if you do, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, and don't forget to hit the bell. So once you have the photo that you want to use loaded into the layers panel, come up here and just duplicate this layer. So right click and choose duplicate, and then just turn that main layer off. And we're going to work with the copy. And then come up here to add a mask and make sure that mask is highlighted. And then come over here and choose the select area tool. And we're going to pick a tool so that we can start selecting our subject to remove the background from. So I like to first of all use the ellipse selection just to make a real quick elliptical selection like this, and then we want to invert the selection because we want to delete the background, and then choose delete selection and then clear the selection. And then we can come up here. We can't really use the magic wand tool because the background is so busy, so there's really no sense in using that one. So I'm going to continue using the ellipse selection just to show you how you can just keep making these selections, these elliptical selections. You can get real close to the edge by doing that. And then just select delete selection, and then clear the selection and just continue on your image until you're satisfied. Or you can switch tools here now if you want. We can choose the lasso selection. I don't have a really steady hand, so I don't really like this tool. So I'm not going to continue showing that one, but you get the gist of it. And then there's this one, the smart lasso selection. And if you just click once and just start dragging your cursor, it adds these little nodes all around your selection. So when you get to the end, you can double click and it will select it, and then you can just choose delete. So bear with me while I do this. And if you go over too far in either direction, this is nice because you can just click on to one of the nodes and move it. So I'll show you that in a moment. And this is nice because it auto selects it, so you don't have to have as steady of a hand because it auto detects the edges. And it does a pretty good job. And you don't have to hold the cursor or hold your mouse button down. You only have to click it once and then just drag your mouse. Or if you have a tablet, then you can use the pen from your tablet. And then we can fine-tune this in a minute. Now see, this is where you can move the nodules. But don't double click just yet because you won't be able to move the nodules. So just click once to close the circle, and then you can come over here and see it kind of highlights each nodule and allows you to move it. So I'm going to make a big movement just so you can see. And just move those like that. And let me just zoom in here so you can see. Kind of a nice feature. When you're not used to it, it is sort of time consuming, so you have to have patience for it. But it will allow you to get a nice clean selection. And then let's fix this area. I'll zoom back out in a second here. And the nice thing with the mask is if we don't like the selection, we can just subtract or add to it. Whereas in previous versions, once you made your selection, that was it. There was no turning back. If you wanted to change it, you'd have to start from scratch again. So this is really nice. It's more like Photoshop. In that regard. And then I messed up here, right around her hair. But we'll fix that with the pen tool. I'll show you that in a minute. Okay, so let's zoom back out. And I'm not going to bother with this down here. So now that we have that done, we can double click. And it made the selection. And now we can invert the selection and select the delete selection. And then clear the selection. So you can see right here along her arm and the sand between her legs and around his feet. So let me show you how you can clean that up. So come over here to the pen tool, and let me zoom in a bit. And I'm going to keep the brush selected and opacity at 100 and normal. The blending mode is normal, and then just you can come and erase that. Now see, if you go over too far on any part, you can just come up here to the pen tool. Whoops, it was already selected. And change your color. So black conceals, black hides, and white reveals. So change the color to white, click OK, and then paint over it, and it brings that back. It reveals it. So black conceals. Let me show you that again. And white reveals it. And you can see if you look over here on your mask, it adds that back in. Well, I don't know if you can see that. It's pretty small. So let me zoom back out. And you can go in here if you want, and if you have a steady hand, and just come in here and erase that. You know, we can zoom in. I don't know what this thing is doing. If you press the space bar, it will give you the hand, and then you can click and drag, but it's acting kind of funny. So sort of glitchy. So just come in here and clean up this stuff. I'm not too worried about the feet because when I add the background, I'm going to move the image so that their feet aren't even in the image anyways. So once you've completed your selection, you can come over here and click on the mask itself and right click and then choose select masked area, and it creates the selection so that you can save it, and then right click again and then save the layer mask, and I'm going to call it couple on each, and then save. And I already saved it, so I'm just going to say replace. And it says it's saving. And then you can choose clear selections to get rid of your selection. So now, if you close out of here, let's say you're not ready to continue working on it, but you want to save it. Let's say you close out of here. Let's just delete the layer. And let's say we're starting from scratch again. Let's assume you just opened the photo. So right click and duplicate. And now let's add a mask. Now right click on the mask and let's load layer mask. And there's the image right there, couple on beach. So double click and select convert the image to grayscale based on its gray level and then say okay. And there's your selection again. So you'll always have it. And if you want to continue, let's say you deleted too much, just click on the pen tool, change the color to white, click OK, and just wherever you want to add the background back in, just do that. So that's a really nice feature to be able to save these masks, these selection masks. So now let's add a background, and I'm just going to add a solid background. This is also new in PhotoDirector 10. So come up here to add new layer, and at the bottom there's add solid color layer. So click that, and we also have the color picker, which is new in PhotoDirector 10. So I'm gonna choose maybe a color out of his shirt here and just click OK, and it automatically picks that color. And if you want to change it, just click on the eyedropper and just drag that over so you can see, and just pick any other color that you want. Just really simple. So I'm gonna make them a little bit bigger. I'm gonna choose the pick and move tool, and then I'm just gonna drag the corner and just resize them a little bit and just move their feet down because we couldn't really salvage them because they were in the sand. So I'm just going to leave that there. And you can add another background if you want, if you wanted to have a half and half background. So just come here to the solid color layer and then add a new layer and add solid color layer. And let's just pick white. So now that we added the white background, it completely covers the background beneath. So let's just remove a part of it. So come over here to the Select Area tool and choose the rectangle selection. And then just make a selection for about half of it. And make sure you're on this solid color white layer, and then click delete selection. And so now you can see the two colors. So then click the X. And if you wanted to add some text over here, you could do that. Or if you wanted to add another layer, you could do that. So come up here and add new layer. This time we're just going to add an empty layer. And we're going to create some shapes. So come over here to the shape tool and select the rectangle. And then just start clicking and dragging and just make a selection. And the color defaulted to black, so we'll just keep that as black. And you can just keep making more if you want. And because they're underneath your main image, they are hidden behind the main image. So if this layer was, let's say it was down here, those lines would be in front. But because it's on top, everything's hidden below. So go back to that shape layer and just keep going until you're satisfied. And if you wanted to add, you know, some other shapes up here, you could do that. And like I said, you can add some text here if you wanted to. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe and make sure you hit the bell so that you're notified when I come out with a new video. Thanks for watching.